come to the next stanza onwards, and you can see their disappointment is so much increased. It is again increased because while they were walking through the road, they could see so many animals and birds. So their condition is not like them. So they, these birds and animals are enjoying their day, but even though Jewish people are human beings, they can't enjoy their life. They can't enjoy their freedom and identity. And when you come to the first part, there he is talking about a poodle. Poodle is a particular kind of pet dog. And so here, and when they have seen looking upon the dog is decorated, having a beautiful dress and all, that you might have seen in pictures. And then in the next line, they have seen a cat is there. When a door is opened, a cat is getting into the house. So there also, for a cat also, there is a home for it. And then in the third line, the poet says, but as we are German Jews, and we have no place to live in. Even a dog and a cat, they have a resting place, and they are taken care of by the people. But only because they are born as German Jews and they are unable to have a place to live in. So that is very pathetic. And so the writer, speaker is very sad about his condition. And when you come to the next line, and now they are going through a harbor, a port where the ships are already anchored. And when they are going there, they have already seen fish is swimming very freely. So many fish is there, but they are not worried about their life, where they go. And they are already having a place to live in, that is an ocean or a river. But even these German Jews, even though these fish has a particular place to live in, they are enjoying their day by swimming here and there. These German Jews, they have no place to live in and they have no time for enjoyment. Their mind is always filled with tension and worry about when Hitler's Gestapo's will come and they will be killed. So that fear is always in their mind. And then when you come to the next line, and there they have seen, when they are walking through a forest, nearby a forest, they saw so many birds are already sitting upon the branches of trees. And they had, and according to the writer, they had no politicians and sang at their ease. So these birds, they are not worried about any politics, any politicians. They are enjoying their day by singing beautiful melodies. But when they have seen these birds, they once again their mind was filled with worries and tension. And so now that is why the last line says they were in human race. So these birds are enjoying their day only because they do not belong to human race. And human race is supposed to be the crown of God's creation. But even though these German Jews are belonging to human race, they are unable to enjoy their day like these birds, like this dog, like this cat, like the fish, etc. And when you come to the next stanza, and there they could see a huge building, a skyscraper maybe. It has got 1,000 floors are there, but and also it has got 1,000 windows, 1,000 doors, etc. But the speaker very sadly is telling that this building contains so many rooms, so many doors, so many windows, but none of them belong to this German Jews. Even though they came to this foreign land in order to save their life, and now they are unable to do that. There is nobody to give them any secure place. They have no place to live in. And then the last stanza is telling, stood on a great plain in the falling snow, 10,000 soldiers marched to and fro. So they imagine at any time, even though it is a very cold winter season, at any time the police or the soldiers of this Hitler, and they will come in search of them even in this foreign country. And so now the speaker is imagining these soldiers are conducting a march to and fro, march in accordance to Hitler's commandment, they must die. So at any time they will be find out and they may be killed. So for as a preparation, these German soldiers may be conducting, they may be conducting a particular march there according to the speaker's imagination. And so now the last line is showing the extreme disappointment of the speaker. He says, looking for you and me. That means the soldiers, and they are not searching for anybody. They are searching for I and you, or me and you. So, and the last line, also shows how much disappointed and insecure they are in this foreigner. Even though they wanted to save their life and run away to another foreign country, even in that foreign country, and their mind is filled with fear about Hitler and also about fear about when they will be killed by the soldiers, etc. So altogether, this lesson is talking about a real incident happened in the history, that is how the German Jews had to escape from Germany for fear of Hitler. So you can go to the three set of questions and find out the answers, and especially you can read out the second paragraph. There the main ideas of the lesson is given, and about W.H. Auden some ideas are given in the first paragraph, and look at all these things and find out an answer to the questions, especially the third set of the question, that is essay question. So go through the lesson well and have a nice day, and we can meet with another lesson in the next year.